My name is Leanne, and I'd like to welcome you to our online service. Today, we are going to learn about how God keeps us safe. Let's open up our Bibles to Psalm 91:2. It says, "The Lord alone is my refuge, my place of safety." I have a question for you guys. Where is your refuge? Where do you feel safe? I like that answer. Very nice. Do you guys know where I feel safe? In my bed. My bed has all my warm blankets, all of my stuffed animals to cuddle with. And speaking of animals, do you guys know the story of Noah? God gave Noah a place of refuge, a place where he could be safe. But before we learn about Noah, we have to make sure that everyone is here. Okay, come on everyone, let's go. Two. Okay, looks like everyone's here. Are you guys ready to have some fun? We have games, dancing, and of course we're gonna visit the What's Gonna Happen lab. Are you ready? Come on, let's go. Bye-bye.
Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us today for worship. So we're gonna pray now. Everyone bow your heads and close your eyes. Dear God, thank you for allowing us to praise you all together with our church family. We are excited to dance and sing songs for you. Help everyone to know you and love you more. In Jesus' name, we pray, amen. Okay, the first song is Peace Like a River. Here are the moves for this song. It's gonna go, peace like a river, peace like a river. And then the next part is gonna go, love like an ocean, love like an ocean. Okay, and the last part is gonna go, joy like a fountain, joy like a fountain. Good job, everyone. Are you guys ready to worship?
Here, and that was an amazing time of worship, wasn't it? Yeah, I think so too. And I love worshiping with everyone together, but I also love to play games. So hopefully you guys are ready to play a game. You guys ready? Okay. Let me get my handy game bowl again. And it looks like today we're gonna be playing 2x2. Some of you may not have heard this game before, so basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna play charades, but we're gonna take turns. So I'm gonna act out something and you guys are gonna guess, and then we're gonna flip the roles and you're gonna act out something, and then I'm gonna try to guess what you're doing. Okay? You guys got it? It'll be easy, trust me. Let's do this. All right, first clue. I'm gonna act this out, you guys guess it. Ready? Anyone get, oh, I think I heard a couple people. Let me hear it one more time. You guys got it. You guys got that so well. It was rain. Rain. Very good. Okay. I'm going to close my eyes in 1 second. You guys are going to see a word on your screen and you're going to act it out and I'm going to try to guess it. Okay. Ready, set, all right. Okay. Go ahead and act it out when you're ready. Oh, I think, oh, you building something? Are you using power tools? I don't think you can do that. Oh, you're building, using wood. No? What is that? Oh, you're building a house. No? Oh, man, what was it? Oh, you were building an ark. Oh, hey, that's my bad, guys. You guys did a great job acting that out. I just didn't get the answer. Okay, let's go on to clue number 3. I'm gonna act this one out, okay? Ready? Anyone get it? I know it was kind of silly. Did you guys get it? It was a certain animal. Oh, I heard one person say it. Let me hear 2 more people say it. You guys are on it. Not one, but 2 flamingos. So a pair of flamingos. Yeah, you guys are on it today. All right, let me see if I can get one for you guys. Ready? I'm gonna close my eyes and you guys act out what you see. Okay. You guys ready? Okay, go. Oh, it looks like my first clue. Okay, there's rain. Uh-huh. Something in the sky. After it rains? Rainbow. Yes, okay, I got one. You guys did an amazing job acting that out. You guys are pros. You guys are really, really good. Hey, so remember all of our clues because they're gonna come back a little later on in the story from the Bible that we're gonna hear. Remember, we got rain, we got an ark that you guys built so well, we have 2 flamingos or pairs of animals, and we also have a rainbow. All right, man, you guys tired me out. I am getting a little bit hungry, and hopefully I can make something with this.
Hi, and welcome to Kids Crew's What's Going to Happen Lab. We are so excited to be here with you guys today. My name is Darren, and I'll be one of your teachers. This is my son, Micah.
Hi.
And my daughter, McKenna.
Hi.
So today, we're gonna learn about a really cool guy named Noah. Now, I'm sure a lot of you guys have heard about Noah before and heard his story, but what I wanted you to know is that God did some amazing things in Noah's life that we get to learn about today. One of the things that I love most about Noah is that he learned how important it was to follow God's instructions. He learned that God's directions are never, ever wrong. And even though God's directions may not always seem practical, Noah learned to follow them with his whole heart. Thankfully, God is never wrong when he gives instructions. And that's not always the case when it comes to us humans. Let's take a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, for example. So how many of you guys know how to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich? Seems pretty simple, right? Well, I asked my kids to write up instructions on how to make one of them. So let's see how they did.
Get 2 pieces of bread. Put peanut butter or some butter on 1 piece of bread.
So, peanut butter. Put the peanut butter on 1 piece of bread. Okay.
Spread it.
Well, that's not what it says. It says put the peanut butter on 1 piece of bread. Got it.
Okay. And put jelly on the other.
Put jelly on the other. Got it?
Put the 2 pieces of bread together.
Put the 2 pieces of bread together. Okay.
Eat.
Okay. This does not taste like a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. So you guys got another set of instructions for me?
Yes.
Okay, let's see how we do. Go ahead, read it.
Get 2 pieces of bread.
All right, get 2 pieces of bread.
Spread peanut butter on 1 piece of bread and jelly on the other.
Spread one, what?
Spread peanut butter on 1 piece of bread and spread jelly on the other.
Spread peanut butter on 1 piece of bread.
Everywhere.
Everywhere.
Not like on the back.
No, I mean just on the front. Just on the front. Just on the front.
Okay, let's.
Okay.
No.
And
jelly on the other.
And jelly on the other. Got it. Everywhere?
No.
It says everywhere.
Oh, no. No.
Okay.
Put the 2 pieces.
Put the pieces together. Okay.
Eat and enjoy.
Eat and enjoy. Not bad.
Dad, that was wrong.
Okay, well, you know, what we learned is that our instructions sometimes are imperfect, but God's plans, His directions are always perfect. And that's what Noah learned about. So you guys are going to learn more about Noah in a little bit, but first you guys get to do some art. So go grab your paper plates and your pens and we'll get ready for an art project.
Tim, this is
Sally.
And we're going to be doing an activity where you're going to do 2 paper plates. How many paper plates do we need, Sally?
2.
All right. And we're going to need a marker or a pencil to do this. If you don't have any paper plates, that's fine. Go ahead and use a piece of paper. And that'll work just perfect. So what we learned about Noah is about how well he listened. So what we want to do is practice our listening skills by following instructions and drawing on the paper plate. However, the hard part is that we're going to be putting this on our heads. Does that sound easy to do?
Yes.
All right, let's try it.
Okay, now let's put the paper plate on our head, hold it with one hand, and use your pencil or marker with the other hand. Now let's draw a rectangle. Very good, nice long rectangle. And right above that rectangle, let's draw a cloud shape. Do your best to draw that cloud shape. How are you doing at home? Good. Now inside that cloud shape, let's draw 5 to 6 small circles. Count them out while you're drawing them. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, find your rectangle and let's go under it and draw a straight line across. Can you draw a straight line across the plate? Good. Now below that line, let's draw some flowers. They could be small, they could be big. But let's draw some flowers under that line.
Take a look. Huh, that doesn't look like the picture we're trying to draw. Let's grab the second plate that you have and try to find a parent or a brother or sister at home to help you out with this next step. Now the parent or sibling is gonna hold your hand while you hold the plate, and we're gonna redraw the picture again.
So what we're going to do is draw a large rectangle. Cool. And above that rectangle is going to be one big cloud. Nice cloud. And inside that cloud, we're going to do 5 to 6 small circles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. How are you doing at home? Did you guys draw 5 to 6 circles?
Yes.
Good. Next, we're going to go to the rectangle and draw a straight line across on the bottom of it. Straight line. And under that line, we're going to draw some flowers. They could be small, they could be big, but we just want to draw some nice, pretty flowers. Alright, let's look at our pictures. Wow, those are some great apple trees. So, when your parent or brother and sister helps you, your picture should look more like an apple tree with some flowers, compared to the one you did alone. In a similar way, God helps us when we need it, and when we listen to Him and allow for Him to guide us, we are pretty much safe. Nice work today, kids! That's great. You gotta get going, Sully. Thank you, everybody. Bye!
Stories of the Bible. Noah and the Flood. This is Noah.
Hey!
Noah was a good man who tried to do the right thing.
Yeah.
But in the time when Noah lived, he was the only man on earth who was doing the right thing. All the other people on earth were doing evil things and hurting each other. This made God very sad. So God said that He was going to send a flood to the earth that would destroy every living thing on earth because He was sorry He ever made them. But God decided to save Noah and his family. God told Noah to build a boat and fill it with 2 of every kind of animal and bird.
Colors, birds, moth, okay, all here.
Noah did just that, and then Noah and his whole family boarded the boat and waited for the flood to come. The rain fell hard for 40 days and 40 nights. Water covered the whole earth, and the boat floated safely on the surface. Water covered even the highest mountains on earth, but Noah and his family were saved. God remembered Noah and all the animals on the boat. God sent a wind to blow across the earth, and the flood began to go away. After 5 months, the boat came to rest on a mountaintop. A few months later, the other mountains could be seen. 40 days later, Noah opened a window and released a raven. The bird flew back and forth until the flood had dried up. He also sent a dove out to see if it could find dry ground, but the dove couldn't find a place to land because there was still water on the ground. So the dove returned to the boat.
Oh, hello again.
After another 7 days, Noah sent the dove out again. This time, it came back with an olive leaf.
Oh, good girl.
So Noah knew that the floodwaters were almost gone. A week later, he sent the dove out again, and it didn't come back. So many months after the flood began, Noah opened the covering of the boat and saw that the ground was drying. He waited 2 more months, and at last, the earth was dry. Then God said to Noah, "Leave the boat, all of you. Release the animals so they can be fruitful and multiply throughout the earth."
Okay.
So Noah, his family, and all the animals finally left the boat.
See ya.
Noah built an altar to the Lord to make a sacrifice to God. God was pleased with Noah's offering and said to himself that he would never again destroy every living thing on earth. God blessed Noah and his sons and promised them that he would never send another flood. He gave them the rainbow in the sky as a sign of this promise to Noah, his family, and all of mankind.
The rainbow in the sky, two of every animal. I know many of you have heard Noah's story since you were very little. And for those of you who didn't know Noah's story, I hope the video you just saw helped you. I want to share a few things I learned from reading about Noah and see how we can apply it to our lives. God told Noah to build a very large boat we call an ark. It was 450 feet long, 75 feet wide, and 45 feet high, much larger than this picture shows. Now, this is interesting because Noah was a farmer. He didn't know anything about building an ark, but he wanted to listen to God, even if it didn't make any sense to him. He trusted God, and God gave him instructions on how to build the ark. It wasn't easy. Noah was 500 years old when he began building the ark, and it took him 100 years to finish. So how old was Noah when he finished building the ark? You got it. He was 600 years old. During the 100 years that he was building and hammering, people around him made fun of him. They couldn't understand why Noah, a farmer, would spend all his time on an ark. Yet Noah listened to God and did what God told him to do. The same should be true for us. We should listen to God. How do we know what God is saying? Most of us don't hear His voice. Well, we know what is good and what is bad from reading the Bible. And we know what is right and what is wrong from listening to our parents. God might not be speaking to us with a voice we can hear, but He is using the Bible and important people like your parents to help us hear Him. Right now, you are all involved in distance learning, meaning you have lessons to do without going to school. It can be tempting to watch TV or play a video game instead of doing your schoolwork. A voice inside you says, "You can do your schoolwork later." But God uses your parents to help you to do the right thing. They would tell you to do your schoolwork first with your best effort before you watch TV or do other things. By listening to your parents, you are listening to God. So I learned that Noah listened to God and he did what God asked him to do. I also learned that God protected Noah and his family and all the animals in the ark. When it rained for 40 days and 40 nights, the whole earth was covered with water. Even the highest mountains were covered with water. The ark became a refuge, a safe place for the people and the animals. They were in the ark for 1 year and 10 days. During that whole time, God provided Noah and the animals with food and shelter. The ark just floated. It had no steering wheel. Yet God guided the ark and kept them safe. We often use things to protect us. If we are going camping, we use a tent to protect us. Of course, our homes are a safe refuge, especially now when we all need to stay at home. But Psalm 91:2 says, "The Lord alone is my refuge, my place of safety." The Lord alone. This means that if a bear should wreck my tent, if my home should be damaged by fire or earthquake, those safe places of safety would be gone. But if we have the Lord Jesus, He will never abandon us, and we can always go to Him to find refuge, a safe place. God keeps us safe. Let's pray right now and thank God. Dear God, thank you for teaching us through Noah's story about how we should listen to you and how you are our refuge, our safe place. Help us to remember that you are always with us. In Jesus' name, amen. Now let's get on our feet for worship time.
Together. Now get ready. We're gonna pass this back on to Leanne. Here we go. Everyone put your arms out. Whoa!
Oh! Whoa!
Oh!
Whoa! I had so much fun with you guys today, and I hope you got to learn something new about Noah's story. Yes, he took two of every animal. And yes, it rained for 40 days and for 40 nights. And yes, God sent a rainbow as a promise. But I hope that you learned that Noah listened to God and followed his instructions even when it didn't make sense. God gave Noah and his family a place of refuge, a safe place in the ark. And the God that Noah knew is the same God that we have today. And God can be our refuge, our safe place, and we can go to him at any time. Remember, Psalm 91:2 says, "The Lord alone is my refuge, my place of safety." Let's close our time in prayer. Lord God, thank you so much for always guiding me. Help me to listen to you better. Thank you that you are my safe zone and I can go to you at any time. This gives me so much comfort. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Boys and girls, I have a challenge for you this week. I'm going to challenge you to listen to your parents and obey their instructions, even when it doesn't make sense. Think you can do it? I think you can. We'll see you next week. Bye!
Thank you, Kids Crew family!